I'm going ahead and I wet this down and everything, and I hosed it out and cleaned it all out, and I have some video of that, and I'll put it at the end. And I have my very dry cement mixture here. Now, we could put a board across here and fill that board in, but with something so small, we're just going to go ahead and patch it up. Don't forget, we mixed it really dry, so it'll actually, you can actually make a corner on there. And we're hoping that it's not going to sag on us. Because it is a very small patch. And I don't want to go through the hassle of getting wood and putting it across there. If it does sag a little bit, let it set up, then come back and hit it again when some of the water content is out of there. Now, of course, the smaller the patch, easier it is to patch it without sag. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and continue on just like I am here. Me and Rob pack that into there. And I'm going to let it set up. And I'm going to come back and smooth it out, hopefully without any kind of sag in here. So here's our patch, and our goal was to do it without having any sag. But I end up having a little bit of sag in there, even though we mixed it up with a very dry mixture. So I waited about an hour, I came back, and we'll see what we can do here. It seems to be a lot stiffer. And I'll just push that back up in there. And even though I thought the sag we had was okay for a patch, as the concrete sets up, it makes it a little stiffer. So if you mix it too wet and you're not, it won't hold the end. Just walk away from it and come back a little bit later on. Okay, I'm probably just going to leave that just like that. Well, maybe not. You're now pushing it back in there, and it's holding up. It's holding in there pretty good. Alright. It is a patch, so I'm not playing with it. It turned out pretty good. Here's a much smaller one. A little bit more appropriate for a little patch room like this. The smaller the patch, the easier it is to not have any fang in it. Alright, you see we have a little bit of sang in there, but if you want to take that out, just let it set up and then come back and bring it over, and the cement will be a lot firmer. If not, you can just leave it like that. Now here's a smaller patch that we did, and I'm gonna let it set up for like an hour or so, or half hour, and not going over that, and that's a pretty nice edge on there. You can see it held in there pretty nice, and it's smooth. Now if you don't want it to be smooth because our concrete run, it's not. I just have a little brush you can go over and roughen it up a little bit. And smooth it in, or you can just go ahead and leave it smooth. Here's what I'm going to use to mix it. I have clay sand, just normal clay sand, and I bought a bag of Portland cement, and it comes in a 94-pound bag, and I just threw it in this container for ease of use. But if you want to keep your Portland, get the most use out of it, put it in a bucket with a lid on it. I have it here because I'm just going to use it all up real quick. So I'm going to go ahead and mix this up. So I'm going to go one part Portland, and three parts sand. Three parts sand. Now my dry mix. And I'm going to add some water to it. And I'm going to mix it a little bit wet. And the more you mix cement, the better it seems to work. It goes dry and wet. Seems to get a lot harder being mixed up. Alright, a little bit of water. Now again, I'm going to mix it a little bit on the other side. Alright, I'm going to continue mixing this and I'll be right back and I'll show you how to finish it up. Okay, you can see that I've added way too much water here. Well, I know it's mixed up pretty good, but I'm going to dial it back in. Throw in some more Portland cement in there. And from here we're gonna make it a real, real stiff mixture. And Portland cement, that consumes water like crazy. It'll make it a wet mixture into a dry mixture. That's what we need. We need it to be dry to hang it on. Alright, it's not bad. I'm gonna get a little bit drier than that. And make sure I get a little bit drier. Alright, a little bit more mixing and we'll have it. Okay, there's our mixture. That's how I mix it up to make that repair. You can see how very dry that is. And that will hold in there real nice, as you saw. And And so I dowel it all in, I mix it real wet, and then I run it back. So there it is. You see when I make a little bowl, but nothing sticks to your hand. That's really somehow a little squash turned into main squash really quick. So the more we get on there and the more cement I can put in there, the better that's gonna, better patch it's gonna be. And after this, I'll hose it down and we'll kind of clean it out even more. Make sure we clean the areas out that we're gonna patch with water.